Well, hey there, everybody. How you doing? Hope you're having a wonderful day or night. Welcome back to my channel. As always, I am Deluxe. All right, doing a What's New in Transformers. Yay, love new stuff. But before that, do me a big favor. Go down and hit me with some likes, shares, prayers, and care bears. Go down and hit that sub button for me if you like the channel. I really appreciate that. You can hit that little bell. It notifies new content. And you can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, or on Facebook. You know it's in the description. It's easy peasy. So lemon squeezy.
And as always, shirts for sale. They're in the description. I got 3 new ones. Do me a big favor. Check them out. If you like one, buy one. All right. We all need new shirts. Do me a favor, go check out Mr. Terry Wong. He's at Terry's TFF's Club. Wonderful man, awesome guy to deal with, man. Easy site, man. It's easy to navigate. Really nice, awesome. He's got everything for you, man. He's got Legends, he's got Third Party, he's got Hasbro, he's got knockoffs. Man, he's got you covered. Transformers galore. Man, free shipping, fast shipping. Wonderful man to deal with, man. Tell him Deluxe sent you. He might even give you a virtual hug. All right.
All right. Up first, as always, add-on kits for days. And it looks like Shockwave's Lab is giving us exhaust pipes for the Siege Optimus Prime. This is SL-65. So yeah, these look really good. It looks a lot better than the little stubby nubs that he comes with. So you just you unscrew it on the back, I think, and you can just tap them on, and they look really good in bot mode and alt mode. Really, they look really nice. So really glad they're doing these. I may pick these up. I don't know. I haven't really picked up an add-on kit for the Siege things yet, but this looks pretty cool. Just a little small little thing that makes it a little better. You know what I'm talking about? So yeah, we got some new exhaust pipes for Siege Optimus Prime from Shockwave's Lab SL-65. Yeah. Then up next, we have some Legends news, and we got some better pics of the Magic Square Legends class Reflector. And man, these look awesome. I know New Age is coming out with theirs too, but you know, they're going back and forth doing other things. So yes, Magic Square Legends Reflector, they can do everything. Looks like they come with some knives, like the Perfect Effect one, or was it? No, Fans Projects had a little small a legend set also, and they came with knives. So yeah, it looks pretty cool. I like them. You can do the, you know, the pose with the, you know, they're all standing, one standing on two of them and everything. So that's pretty cool. And these look really nice, and it turns into a camera. And they're doing what the Siege thing did. They use the guns as a tripod, so that's pretty cool. So they're using everything to, you know, mesh with everything. So pretty cool. I'm definitely in for these. Anything Magic Square comes out with, I'm definitely in. So yeah, we got some images of Magic Square Legends Reflector. Also in the Legends news, we got some new images of the Iron Factory Bludgeon. So this is the second bomber of the Iron Warrior series. The armor can be moved into full width without interfering with the mobility of the limbs, which is really cool. I think with, you know, when Transformer has swords, it has to have great articulation just to, you know, to use them and everything. So this is looks really nice and really nice articulated. The mobility of the limbs, yeah, the ghost face eyes are transparent, and the helmet antenna is soft to prevent breakage. They got double katanas that has 6 optional mounting points, and also supports a variety of grasping and shaking types. The picture is a trial painting color, so this might not be the following colors, but you know, they're just showing what it will look like also. So very nice. He can get in a sitting pose, that's awesome. This looks really good. I'm really impressed, and I'm definitely in on this one. So yeah, Iron Factory Bludgeon, some new pics from them. Also from Iron Factory, we're getting new images and I think final color pics of the Primal Commander. I think he should be almost ready to come out, just like their Megatron. So this is Optimus Prime from the Beast Wars. He's a quadruple changer, and he looks really good. Really beefy, really nice paint. I love that silver, and then got the red and the kind of orange mix and blue and everything. So it's got some wonderful colors on it, and looks pretty cool. Turns into 4 different things, and that's awesome. You know, that's cool they're pulling that off. So yeah, we got new images of Iron Factory Primal Commander. This is their Optimus Prime, and he should be ready to come out. Yay. Then up next, we got Mechanic Toys. I don't think I've ever heard of them. Are they Mech Fans Toys? Are they like a subgroup of them or something like that? Anyways, they're giving us Mozart. They're giving us a Legends Mohawk. So Mohawk is getting some love. I'll talk about Mohawk in a little bit. But yeah, we're getting a Mechanics Toys Mozart Mohawk. So this is a the movie, you know, from the movie collecting series. You know, the character is about 6.5 centimeters, so he's going to be really short. You can see he's next to the twins, you know, the ice cream truck and everything, so it's really small. So it might could, you know, blend in with that and everything. So, you know, you can blend in with the chug and stuff. So yeah, I guess we're getting a new movie Mohawk from Mechanic Toys. If anybody hit me up in the comments, have they put out anything else before? I don't know for sure, but Yeah, I guess Mohawk is getting some love, so there you go. So we got some new pics from New Age Amy, which I don't know why they called it that. This is Sunstorm, and he looks awesome. I love that he's got a different facial expression than what Starscream has. He's got kind of like that laughing and everything. This looks beautiful. It's got the flames on the, you know, side things. That's pretty cool. I love the promotional pics, man, with the lightning and everything. That looks really good. I wish I could take pics like that, but this looks really cool. I'm definitely in on this. A New Age, you got me. Anything, especially for the Seekers, you got me for the Seekers, man. I got Skywarp coming in, and I can't wait to get Thundercracker and getting this one. So very nicely done. I love, it's got the Takara kind of paint job for it, you know, the nice, you know, kind of mustard, kind of yellow and everything. So it looks really good. So very nice. This is New Age Amy, also known as Sunstorm. And up next, we have New Age Ghost Lucifer. Yay. I'm so excited for this. I love this. Man, New Age, you got me for everything. And I'm loving the Seekers. And this just looks so good. It looks beautiful. It looks so lickable, like a bunch of Jolly Ranchers. Man, this looks good. I got the nice jazz hands. You got the nice, it's a nice bot mode and alt mode. Looks beautiful. So very nice. And it looks like it comes with, is that Metroplex Eye? I can't remember. I think it's Metroplex or Triptychon. I think it's Metroplex Eye. Is that coming as an accessory? That's pretty cool. Then we see Unicron. Are they making a Unicron? I doubt it, but you know, it's pretty cool little, you know, setup, you know, scene right there. I like that picture. It's pretty cool. But this is really neat. I'm loving this, and I can't wait to get this. You get the coordination set. That's awesome. That's beautiful. So really looking forward to this. This is New Age Ghost Lucifer. Yay. And moving on to MP scale news, got a couple box picks, you know, stuff that's really coming out soon. They're just showing some box picks. I thought, you know, maybe show these. Trenchcraft Mohawk, like I was talking about the Legends class. Well, their Mohawk is also coming out. Mohawkin. Yeah, I'm trashing names, I'm sorry. But yeah, this looks like it's ready to come out. It's got the unbox picks, and it shows the, you know, the alt mode and everything. So pretty cool from Transcraft. And looks like Devil Savior's Split is their Mix Maxer is coming out really soon. So I think this is the first one that's coming out of their Devastator from the Babeverse movies and everything. So yeah, we're getting this real soon. So Split from Devil Savior. And finally, Silver Warrior is giving us their General Grant. It's coming out really soon. Should be out anytime. So General Grant, their Optimus Prime, the War Within one. Pretty long box, 43 centimeters, 16 centimeters wide, and 18 centimeters tall. So yeah, final of the three boxes, and three stuff that are coming out real soon. And from Zeta, it looks like we got some better picks from their Pioneer. This is their Bumblebee, which is in the Bumblebee movie. And they gave us a price also. Chosen Prime and some Big Bad Toy Store has a price of $170. Ooh. But you can get them for $100 overseas, I think. They're showing up there. So I don't know what the price hike up is for that, but I don't know. It looks pretty good. I may get this. I don't know. I love my 3A one, but it doesn't transform, and this one does. So it looks pretty good. It's got a nice assortment of you know, weapons. It's got the hammer and everything. A bunch of light up gimmicks, you know, the headlights. His eyes light up, and his fusion cannon lights up and everything. So that could be a reason why the price is a little, you know, steep and everything. But new images of Zeta ZV-01 Pioneer. This is their Bumblebee from the Bumblebee movie. And just real quickly, just showing all the Bumblebees are out right now. You got 3A, you got Zeta, Transcraft, Transform Element, you got the Takara one. So there's just tons of Bumblebees out there for you. So yeah, there you go. Tons of yellow. All right, up next, I showed this guy on my last What's New, and this is the Planet X Jupiter Metallic version. So it's gonna be repainted at the beginning of the next year. Repaint will be a full metal paint spray process to achieve better visual effects and everything. So this looks cool. You know, it's giving us a little different metallic version of the original Jupiter or Optimus Prime from the games and everything. Love, like I said, I still love the axe and the accessories. Really nice. So pretty cool. If you like Planet X and this Optimus Prime, you got the metallic version for you. And also from Planet X, we got their Victory Leo, which combines with their Star Saber and everything. And this is the soap edition, because you know, it's all white and everything. It's kind of soapy. But yeah, this is a nice little add-on kit for him, and it looks pretty good. I love that sword. I love that pose. It's really nice and everything. So yeah, Planet X is giving us a Victory Leo. All right. And in some exciting news, we got a new company coming abroad, and it looks, you know, pretty cool. I'm glad that we're getting new third-party companies, you know, coming around. And I'm more likely they're, you know, other companies that are just branching off or something. They don't really want to be known as their other name brand. So I don't know. But Lemon Trees Toys is giving us a movie Optimus Prime from the Bumblebee movie once again. we're getting tons of these things. I mean, golly. But yeah, this looks decent. I mean, I'm probably not in it for this one. They do have another guy coming up that I'll probably get. But yeah, this is going to be 15 centimeters tall. So there's going to be, you know, around, you know, Chug scale, maybe Voyager scale or something like that. So, you know, nice and detailed. I love the abdomen area and all that stuff. Truck mode looks pretty good, decent. I'm like, I might be in this. I don't know. Who knows? But we're getting a Lemon Tree Toys Movie Optimus Prime. And also from Lemon Tree Toys, which they could be with Banana Force. I don't know, all these, you know, fruits and everything. Looks like we're getting another contender for the new movie Starscream. This is the Tetrajet version and everything. And it looks decent. I like the other company. It looks a lot better. I'll show you comparisons in a little bit. But yeah, we're getting a new Starscream from the movie, which is really cool. I love a new Seeker. I love a new Starscream anytime. So you know they're going to get tons of recolors out of this. And it looks all right. You know, the alt mode looks kind of, you know, weird. The nose cone looks really skinny. It might, you know, be easy to break. So got to be careful with that. But this looks decent. But yeah, here's the comparison with a Lemon Tree, and then you got the Cyber Factory, which I'm really in on the Cyber Factory. It looks better detailed. It just looks beefier. It looks just better overall, in my opinion. I'm still in for the Lemon Tree. You know, I'm going to give it a try and see how they are. But man, I'm definitely in for that Cyber Factory. That looks so good. So yeah, we're getting a new, you know, kind of a Starscream war between Lemon Factory and Cyber Factory. So yay, Lemon Tree, not Lemon Factory. And also from Lemon Tree, they kind of teased us with the Galvatron ship, Revenge from the A6 movie. I have no idea what this is. It's really small, but are they going to do, is this going to be like a little accessory with one of their figures or something? Or are they actually making a big ship of this? I have no clue, but they teased us with this little silhouette, which I miss silhouettes. That's awesome. So yeah, the Galvatron ship Revenge from the A6 movie from Lemon Tree. All right, in official news, it looks like 3-0, which used to be 3-A, is giving us a deluxe scale Soundwave and Ravage from the Bumblebee movie as announced. So the new action figure is scaled down version. It's going to be premium scaled. It's going to be really nice, I guarantee you. I love the 3-A and 3-0 stuff so far. I'm waiting for that Prime to come out. But we're getting a Soundwave, which is cool. You know, eventually they're going to do all that. You know, hopefully the first 10 minutes they'll do all those figures. You know, RC, Ironhide, Cliffjumper. But yeah, we're getting a new deluxe scale Soundwave and Ravage. This doesn't transform, so it's just a, you know, action figure. So very cool. I'm definitely in for this one. So we got some in-hand images of the Studio Series SS-59 Shatter. This is the Jet mode, which I hope is a lot better. That Car mode one was not good at all. It's probably the worst Studio Series figures in my opinion. Not everybody's, but in mine, it was not that good. The Karma was pretty good. But anyways, we got in-hand images of Shatter, and she looks pretty good. I love the bot mode, and the jet mode looks really good, too. So I'm really excited to get this one. Hopefully, like I said, it's going to be better than the car mode. So yeah, definitely getting the Studio Series SS-59 Shatter. This is the jet mode. All right. So real quickly, we got some updates of the Takara Tomy's Raiden project. This is the train bot combiner thing. So there's no official release date yet. Raiden was a Japanese exclusive train combiner and is going to be confirmed to release in the Masterpiece line. So that's pretty cool. They just want to bring trains to the great train fan base of Japan. The project will be taken by senior Takara Tomy designers this time. So yeah, just a little update. They are going to be MP scaled. I'm excited. I really want to see Takara do some combiners. Hopefully they'll do some more after this one. But yeah, so some updates for a Raiden project from Takara. So a little update for the Cyberverse line. We got, and this is on Walmart.com. They saw some new listings for the Ultra Class Skullcruncher and Thunder Howl. So if you're a big Cyberverse collector, which I'm not, I have a couple, but you know, I'm just not really in it on the line. We're definitely getting some new stuff, and Walmart.com is showing us Ultra Class Skullcruncher and Thunder Howl. So pretty cool. And also on Walmart.com, we're getting a new Studio Series Revenge of the Fallen Soundwave. So this is when he was in the satellite mode. So pretty cool. You know, so they're showing us a listing of this. You know, eventually I know they're going to do all the, you know, the movie stuff from the Bayverse. So, you know, I knew this was going to come along. So pretty cool. This is from the TF2 Soundwave. And so he's a satellite. So, yep, new Studio Series. Yay. Well, all right. I hope you liked that little slideshow of up and coming new stuff. I'm excited. We got some new Legends. We got some new MP scale stuff. We got some Studio Series. We got some new Bumblebees. Golly, tons of Bumblebees and Optimus Prime from that movie. Oh my goodness. So, I hope you like this. Hit me up with some likes, shares, prayers, and care bears. Go down and hit that sub button for me if you don't mind. Hit that comment button. Tell me what you thought of this. If you like the, you know, what's new and everything. And I guess I'll see you on the next What's New in Transformers. And as always, be good to yourself. Hail Hasbro. And good night, folks.